everyone, today we're going to be making a new video about computer-based national examination, how visual spatial learners prepare for it. First of all, what is multiple intelligences are?
The theory of multiple intelligence was developed in 1983 by Dr. Howard Gardner, professor of education of Harvard University.
It is based on IQ testing. There are 8 of them, but today we'll only explain about the visual spatial. Visual spatial usually teach or learn with pictures, and they usually like to watch movies, painting, drawing, and etc. So let's start.
Visual spatial. Think in terms of physical space as to architects and sailors. Kinesthetic. Use the body effectively like a dancer or a surgeon. Musical. Show sensitivity to rhythm and sound. Interpersonal. Understanding interacting with others. Intrapersonal. Understanding one's own interests, goals. Linguistic. Using words effectively. Logical, mathematical, reasoning, calculating. Naturalistic. Observes the law in the natural world. Few percent of naturalistic, 6% of linguistic, 16% of musical, 19% of visual spatial, 12% of logical mathematical, 19% of kinesthetic, 19% of interpersonal, and 6% of intrapersonal. 0% of linguistic, 10% of musical, 32% of visual spatial, 0% of logical mathematical, 11% of kinesthetic, 26% of interpersonal, 5% of intrapersonal, 60% of naturalistic, 10% of linguistic, 23% of musical, 10% of visual spatial, 3% of logical mathematical, 6% of kinesthetic, 23% of interpersonal, 19% of intrapersonal, and 3% of naturalistic. When do you normally study after school? 15% before exam, 8% morning, 56% evening, 31% midnight. Where is your preferred study location? 7% school, 8% living room, 8% course teacher, 77% bedroom. How do you resolve your anxiety during exams? 37% pray, 12% drink water, 13% eat, 38% calm down. What kind of pen you usually have in doing your exam? 37% start from the heart, 13% start from the bottom, 38% start from the top, 12% start from the easy.
Hello, my name is Priscilla, I'm an education, and today I'm going to interview her. Question number 1. You like art, don't you? What about exam? Can you tell us a little bit about what you feel when exam week is coming?
Yes, I like art. I feel nervous because I don't prepare anything for exam.
Question number 2. When you're dealing with exam week, what kind of tactics that you usually use?
I'm sleep. After I sleep, I study with my teacher.
Question number 3. Can you give us some tips to deal with our exam that you usually use?
Sleep, calm down, and pray.
Question number 4. When you study your exam and you don't get the point, what do you usually do?
I usually sleep a lot of night.
Question number 5. When you're tired after studying for your exam, what do you usually do? Like drawing or sketch or even watch movie. Can you tell us what kind of topic you usually pick?
I usually watch a movie like.
Yeah, I do like art, and when I study,
My hand cannot stop drawing.
Question number two. When you're dealing with exam weeks, what kind of tactics that you usually use?
I don't know, sometimes I just draw when I start.
Question number three. Can you give us some tips to deal with your exam that you usually do?
I don't have any tips.
Question number four. When you're studying your exam and you don't get a point, what do you usually do? For examples like, do you usually make mind map to understand it?
Yeah, I do make mind map and I write the rule.
Question number five. When you're tired after studying for your exam, what do you usually do? Like drawing or sketch?
I just sketch.
Even watch movies. Can you tell us what kind of stuff do you usually make?
I just sketch.
Overall, thank you. For today, she's our last guest, named Gladys. Question number one, you like art, don't you? What about the staff? Can you tell us a little bit about what you do when the exam week is coming? Question number three, when you're dealing with exam weeks, what kind of tactics do you usually use? Can you give us some tips to do with your exam that you usually do?
First, don't play with your phone before you exam.
Question number four. When you're studying your exam and you don't get a point, what do you usually do? For example, like, do you usually make mind map to understand it? When you're tired after studying for your exam, what do you usually do? Like drawing or sketch or even watch movies? Can you tell us what kind of topics you usually make?
I usually watch movies.
It's done for today. Thank you guys.
Indonesia had its first national exam in 1965. Just after independence, according to the Education Ministry's website. In 2003, the national exam was centralized, a national body prepared the questions, and the government set a minimum passing grade, which is increased periodically. In 2011, the government decided to weigh the national exam alongside local school exams, which are given at the end of each term. The national exam then accounted for 60% of each students' graduation evaluation, while the school exam comprised 40%.
What was your preparation like?
Start the end doing some questions and reading some books.
How did you feel during the test? How
much was it?
What was the result?
Quite good.
What are your suggestions for your juniors for the upcoming
First, include illustrations as you take notes in class. Second, create graphic organizers such as diagrams and concept maps. Third, when reviewing information, rewrite or draw the information from memory. Fourth, when taking notes, replace words with symbols wherever. Fifth, watch videos about topics you are studying in class.
Thank you for watching.